Right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go through step by step. I mean, literally, hopefully to the micron on how to do a mix using vinyl turntables. Decks I've got are the PLX 1000 from Pioneer DJ. We have the DJM 250 Mark II, and I've got the headphones as well. Okay, so what do we do? I'll show you. Okay, so I've got here a track, Central Park Recordings, Daddy J featuring Face Electric City Part 1. And over here, Martin Venotogjug, something like that, featuring Derek Conyer, a track entitled Really Don't Stop. I mean, really don't stop. Okay, so I'm going to play this first, so let's put the needle on the record. And also, if I put that centre and that centre, so... you know, you can tell that I haven't already gotten beat matched. So if I just put this on here, and, this isn't step by step, this is just showing. There you go, you can hear they're off, okay? All right, so let's imagine that this track here playing, all right? So that's playing now. So I'm just going to put the needle off the record and just imagine that's playing, all right? So my first, the first procedure I need to do, or what I need to do again first, is get the other record ready, of course. So taking out the cover, I'd put it on. I would then put the needle on the record like that. Now I would now press my cue button on the left-hand side, because I want to hear this track through my headphones and not through the PA. Because if I put the needle on the record, put the volume up and started to play it, you would indeed hear that track over that track. We don't want that to happen. So what I'm about to show you now is the procedure and what you would hear if you had your headphones on and you were listening to this track. So again, that one's playing. Imagine that track is playing, people are dancing to it, and they're having a good time, and you're now ready to put this track on. So of course, needle on the record, the volume is down. You want to make sure that the volume, of course, on your mixer is down, because if it's up, the sound, however far it's up or however far it's up, the sound or some of it may bleed through into the other sound that's playing that people are listening to. So what I'm about to show you now is what you would hear if you had your headphones on. And to do that, of course, I need to just put the volume up. So what you're about to hear now would not be what the public are listening to. It would be what you could hear on your headphones. So needle on the record, press play. And what I'm going to do now is spin it forward. There, I'm getting my first beat. And now I have queued that up. All right, I've got that ready. So now what we need to do is we need to make sure that that track is in beat with that track. So the way to do that, of course, is to play them together. Now I'm going to play them together twice. The first time I'm going to play them together is with this track playing so you can hear it, and I can hear this track on my headphones, but you can't hear this track. And then I'll beat them, match the beats, and then just bring this track in very quickly. The second time I do it, I will play this track over that track so you can hear the two tracks together. And so we know where we are. At the moment, I've got the pitches dead centre, and as you heard earlier, they're offbeat. So let me do that first. So I'm going to first use my headphones, bring that one up, put that on there. My headphones. Now they're in beat. Okay, so let's stop that. Now again, I'm going to try and cover as much as I can. Now, when you are beat matching using vinyl, the same with MP3 or CDs or anything, quite often what you'll see the DJ do is when he or she is getting it in beat, they won't wait for the end of the phrase, wait for the beginning of a new phrase. They'll just start beat matching it any place, because when you're beat matching a track, you're not trying to find the beginning of a phrase or the beginning of the vocals, the end of the vocals. You just want to match it. You just want to make sure it's in time. And you can do that anywhere in the track. So long as you start the track you're mixing in on the count of one in a bar, and you match that on the track that's playing. Now, I'm going to show you now exactly what I did with the volumes both up. So let's put that back to the center and let's get the beginning of this one again. So remember the needle on the record, put it forward. There it is. Whoops. Alright, so the next thing we need to do is once we've got it in beat, we then need to make sure we bring it in at the right time. So the first procedure is, of course, make sure it's in beat. The next one is bring it in beat, but at the right time. Now with vinyl, vinyl's difficult because unless you've got two copies of the same track, you can't say, excuse me, ladies and gentlemen, I do apologise, I did a really crap mix there, I didn't match it in beat properly. One second, or something like this. You can't do this. Here we go. So you're trying to get it in beat, you can't, you've gone past your cue point. Oh, I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen, do apologise, I got that beat, I've just got to start it again, so I'm going to rewind the track, I'm going to just put it back a bit. You can't do that, all right? So there is very little room for error when using vinyl. All right, so I've explained about getting it in beat. Also, something that is quite important is your headphones. Now, you'll notice that I have one ear over, I have one ear cup over one ear and the other ear is left open. Now, this is how I monitor. I like to use my right ear for monitoring the track I'm listening to before it comes into the mix, and my left ear is there to monitor and listen to the main PA. Also, what I'm always making sure I do is that my headphone volume, audio, the actual amount of volume I can hear on my headphone is equivalent to the volume I can hear on the main PA. Now, this is a lot to do with SPL, sound pressure level. Because my headphone is a lot closer to my ear, it means that that doesn't have to be as loud as the PA system. If my headphone was as loud as the PA system, I would never DJ again because I would be deaf. Pardon? So, you don't want that to happen. So very quickly, it's a little bit like a weighing scales. If you look at it logically, you've got a pair of weighing scales, you put flour on one side, cocaine on the other, you want to match them up, and you just make sure they're equal. And make sure you take the cocaine with you because it's probably worth a lot more than the flour. Unless, of course, it's an orchid. In that case, it's probably worth more than the cocaine. Right, so I've done that. Now what I want to do is make sure that I know where I'm going to start my track in phrase and time with the other one. Now, you may see a lot of DJs that are doing this all the time, back and forwards, and then they drop it in. Now that's fine if your turntable is set correctly and you know 110%, sorry, beg your pardon, 111% that your piece of vinyl, the needle isn't going to jump off that groove, and just that split second before you want to bring it in, it jumps off and you've lost your cue point. And that happens so many times. It's happened to me a million and one times. So the best thing to do is once you've set that piece of vinyl at the beginning of the beat, Just leave it. Just don't touch it. Leave it alone. Until, of course, maybe two or so bars before you want to bring it in. And then get it ready. Make sure it's in beat. Throw it in. All right. Now, also, towards the end of this video, I'm going to explain how you can get out of jail free. In other words, just in case you do make a mistake, don't worry about it. And I'll show you while we're doing the mix as well. So let's just play this. So I've got that in beat, bring the volume down. I've got my cue on this side here. I waited for the phrase. I brought it in phrase with this track over here. Okay, so what happens then if we miss our cue point with vinyl? Now, if you are, and this is something I advise you not to do if you're a beginner DJ, just using vinyl, and real vinyl, not virtual vinyl, because you can, of course, flip it back and start again or set cue points. But what I would advise you definitely 11% not to do is wait till the very end of the track. In other words, the very last phrase and bring your next one in. Simply because, as I said earlier, if that track finishes, it's finished. And then you've got to like have a bit of a silence and start the track. So what I recommend you do is if you're going to bring your next track in at the beginning, end of a set phrase where you know you want to bring it in, have a contingency plan of the next phrase or the next one. So in other words, if you want to start the track, say on this side, on my left, and I wanted to start it at the beginning of the chorus, but I missed the beginning of the chorus, I need to make sure that I can still bring that track in, say, at the end of the chorus, or at the beginning of a verse, or the end of the verse. So let's do that right now. So, here we go. So this is where it would have been in the mix now, and, all right, I lost my cue point. So I'm waiting for the next phrase. Phrase there. Okay, I'm not going to repeat this video. I was actually out of phrase there. So let me bring it back where that bass line started, okay? Now, all right, so I was slightly out of phrase there. The bass line started. Now let's imagine, all right, I'm just trying to think out loud here, that first of all, I brought it in at the wrong place. Secondly, when that bass line started, it's like, that's the beginning of a new phrase. What I can do then is start counting from there, and then, sure enough, again, dance music, we have 4s, 8s, 16s, 24s, 32s. Just wait for the next phrase. So let's go back. So let's wait for that bass line. So imagine I'd have brought it in, it's the wrong place, and then that bass line starts. So, you know, let's pretend it's still playing. And I'm like thinking, great. And I'm thinking, yeah, this is great. And I'm going like, oh, that's where it was. So that's where it was. As it jumped. Slight change there, that tells me it's not so much a new phrase, but that was definitely an even number, probably an 8. Here we go. There, melody started. So what I tried to do there, and what I did do, is make sure that when I did indeed bring that track in, I brought it in at a new phrase. So again, for the complete beginner, what is a new phrase? It's like, A new phrase can be the beginning of the vocals. It could be the end of the vocals. It could be the beginning of the chorus, the verse, the instrumental break, the end of the instrumental break. It could even be right at the beginning of the track. If you listen to your tracks, you will find that it's always an even number, unless, of course, the producer was on cocaine. Right, so it's either going to be at the beginning of the track, maybe where the bass line starts, maybe where the bass line ends, the vocal start, the vocal ends, the melody starts, the melody ends. Even if that is not the beginning of a phrase, it will be inside that phrase. So what I want you to do, a bit of homework here, is listen to your tracks and maybe listen to where the melody starts. Count how many bars there are before that melody finishes. And I guarantee you it's going to be, if it's a radio version, 2 or 4 bars. If it's an extended version, more likely it's going to be 8, 16, 24, 32. Practice and enjoy. Thank you.